We're going to talk about maximizing the heat transfer from a surface to a moving fluid around that surface. The devices that we use for doing this are called fins, and we can find them in many, many places. But first, let's just think about it. That's a convection heat transfer process. We have a surface at some temperature, or a surface at some range of temperatures, and we have a fluid surrounding it that's going to result in some convection coefficient. And we know from Newton's law of cooling that the heat transfer is going to be equal to the convection coefficient times the surface area times the temperature difference. Now, we don't usually have a lot of control over the temperature difference. Perhaps it's a computer chip and we need to maintain that chip temperature below a certain value. And we have access to the air around us that's at a reasonably fixed temperature. So we can't really change the temperature or the temperature difference very much. We can change the convection coefficient if we put larger and larger fans, and we can change the geometry to some extent, and we have some limited degree of freedom on changing the convection coefficient. But if we're doing that by moving a fluid with a fan, we have to pay for the expense and the energy of driving that fan, and that will take away from the power, or add to the power requirements. And so the other variable that we have to play with is the surface area. We can increase that surface area, and that will increase the fin, the heat transfer rate from that surface. You can find fins across many, many different applications. If you look at the back of a power amplifier, or perhaps open up your computer box, you'll see this very old processor, but it's got a fin array on it. It's got a fan stuck on that to in order to blow the air over it. But we're trying to remove heat from this computer chip into these greatly extended surface area parts in order to maximize the heat transfer. Fins come in many different shapes and sizes. It isn't always from a computer part. Sometimes we have a heat exchanger. We may have a liquid flowing on the inside of a pipe, and we want to maximize the heat transfer. And so here, what we have are a whole bunch of annular fins added on top of this pipe to increase the heat transfer from this pipe to whatever fluid is going over it. And so that's the basic element of many different heat exchangers. Computers have many interesting examples of fins. And recall that we need to minimize the contact resistance. This is a heat sink that would have gone on some computer chip. Again, a fan to give us the convection over those surfaces. And you can see at the base here, there's a remnant of the thermal paste that would use to attach this to the chip that needed to be cooled. And we have a very high conductivity copper surface here, which is drawing the heat from that surface up through the core of this to be dissipated through all of these fins, which have a fairly interesting geometry, as you can see there. Now, the result of that geometry in combination with the way this fan is moving is going to control where that convection coefficient is, but we're going to greatly enhance the heat transfer by having all of these fins there. They come in many shapes and sizes. Here's a fin array where we have rectangular cross-section fins and a whole bunch of them to reduce, to remove heat transfer from the surface below. Here's another case of a geometry where we have fins which are just long, high aspect ratio rectangular fins. I look around you and you'll see many different types. In fact, walking out of my office, you can see the liquid oxygen tanks for Kingston General Hospital. And of course, liquid oxygen is quite cool. It has to be maintained at a cool temperature. You have to reject the heat from the liquid oxygen or it will evaporate, resulting in high pressures in a dangerous situation. And so there is active cooling, and you can see the fin arrays that are rejecting the heat from that liquid oxygen so that we have oxygen to use in the hospital. Let's quickly look inside a computer box. Here's my Mac Pro that has 2 6-core processors, which I use to solve a bunch of heat transfer and computational fluid dynamics problems, amongst other things. But what you can see in here is that we have 2 of the processors, each with 6 cores, buried underneath these heat sinks. And again, it's a fairly elaborate array of fins. Again, a structure which is bringing the heat. You can see the copper in there, which is bringing the heat from that processor and distributing it out to these different fin arrays. There's lots of surface and area in there in order to reject that heat. And if you look closely, again, you can see that there is a fan inside there, as well as a fan inside the case of the computer to draw air over those surfaces and maintain the temperature of these fins. Maintain the temperature of these processors where they need to be in order to work properly and last a long time. So we'll look at this in more detail in subsequent videos.